बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 10 फ्रॉम द सिलेबस एंड नेम्ड एज प्रोटीन बाइंडिंग। इन दिस चैप्टर द बेसिक कंटेंट्स आर इंट्रोडक्शन, मैकेनिज्म ऑफ प्रोटीन ड्रग बाइंडिंग, बाइंडिंग ऑफ ड्रग टू ब्लड कंपोनेंट्स, टिश्यू बाइंडिंग ऑफ ड्रग्स, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन ड्रग बाइंडिंग, फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग प्रोटीन ड्रग बाइंडिंग, significance of protein tissue binding of the drug and kinetics of the protein drug binding. So let us start that what is protein drug binding. The phenomenon of the complex formation of drug with the protein is called protein drug binding. The proteins are particularly responsible for such an interaction. A drug can interact with the several tissue components, of the which the major two categories are blood, and which includes plasma proteins and blood cells. As you all know that blood cells are the red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets, while the component of the blood without blood cells is known as plasma. So there are proteins in the blood cells or also in the plasma. Next category is the extravascular tissue proteins, that contains fats, bones, because our body consists of many proteins. So protein drug binding, or in other words the physiological distribution of the drug in the body, will be discussed in this chapter. So as you can see in the figure that there are two sites of the drug interactions. Number one is the blood and number two is the tissue. In the blood, the drug will be present in bound drug or free drug. This free drug will be available for the tissues or will be available from the blood to the target site. So in the tissues, there are also drug will be present in the two forms. Number one in the bound drug and number two will be in the free drug. The free drug will be responsible for the therapeutic target and it is also will be cleared from the body, while bound drug will not be cleared from the body until it will be free from that proteins. So this chapter or this topic is most important, because to find the drug interactions or to find the fate of or distribution of the drug in the body, the plasma protein binding or tissue protein binding will be very important. This can understand by this figure, which means that when the drug is absorbed from either route, either it will be GIT or it will be pulmonary or it will be different routes. So the drug in the blood will be free drug in the plasma or plasma protein drug in the plasma. So the free drug in the plasma will reach the receptor and the pharmacologic and therapeutic response will be achieved, while protein bound drug in the plasma will remain in the blood and no pharmacologic response, therefore no therapeutic action of this drug. So our fate of the drug will not be reached to the blood. Instead, the fate of the drug will be free form of the drug at the target site. Protein binding, which may be also divided into the intracellular binding and extracellular binding. In intracellular binding is that where drug is bound to the cell protein, which may be a drug receptor, and binds an pharmacological response. These receptors with which the drug interact to show the responses are called primary receptors. While extracellular binding is that where the drug binds to an extracellular protein, but binding does not usually elicit a pharmacologic response. These receptors are called secondary or silent receptors. So as you can see that for the drug action or therapeutic response, intracellular binding is necessary, while extracellular binding will not elicit a pharmacologic response, and so it will be a useless for a drug. As you can see in the figure that here is the at time zero or within no time drug plus plasma protein. Drug will be in the form of the small blue circles, while the plasma protein represents purple circles which you are seeing. At zero time, drug will be in the blood and there is no concentration or unbound concentration in the body, and so there is no pharmacologic response. While at passing of time, or 3 to 5 volts, total concentration represents that the free drug or unbound drug will move from plasma or blood into the target sites, and so this free amount of the drug will be used for therapeutic response. So now, coming towards the mechanisms of the protein drug binding. As you all know that from the previous discussion, it has been shown that there are two types of binding, but the binding with the plasma proteins or and blood cells, and binding with the tissue cells, and so the binding will be either intracellular or extracellular. So in this topic, we have to discuss that how the protein and drug complex can be formed and what is the mechanism of the protein drug binding. So drug protein binding may be reversible or an irreversible process. This is very important to note that there are two mechanisms which may be reversible or irreversible process. While the first one is the irreversible drug protein binding. Irreversible drug protein binding is usually a result of chemical activation of the drug, which attaches themselves strongly to the protein or macromolecule by covalent bonding. Irreversible drug binding accounts for the certain types of tissue toxicity or carcinogenicity. For example, the hepatotoxicity of the high doses of acetaminophen is due to the formation of reactive metabolites that interacts with the liver protein, and the reaction will be irreversible. So next is the reversible drug protein binding. Binding of drugs to proteins is generally reversible, which suggests that it generally involves weak chemical bonds such as hydrogen bonds, hydrophobic bonds, ionic bonds, and van der Waals forces of attraction. The protein bound drug is large complex, therefore has a restricted distribution. The protein bound drug is usually pharmacologically inactive. The free or unbound drug crosses cell membrane and it is therapeutically active. So now let us start the binding of drugs to blood components. Number one is the plasma protein drug binding. Drug interacts with the blood components like plasma proteins, blood cells, hemoglobin when it enters into the systemic circulation. The binding of drug to the plasma protein is reversible. The extent or order of binding of drug to plasma protein is albumin, alpha 1 acid glycoproteins, lipoproteins, and globulins. So first start that binding of drugs to the human serum albumin. It is the most abundant protein, 59%, and it is also present in the extracellular fluid of the skin, muscle, and various other tissues. Molecular weight of the human serum albumin is the 65,000 Dalton with a large drug binding capacity. It is responsible for maintaining the osmotic pressure of the blood and for the transport of exogenous and endogenous substances. Both endogenous compounds such as free fatty acids, bilirubin, various hormones, cortisone, aldosterone, thyroxine, as well as drug binds to HSA. Four different sites on the HSA or human serum albumin for drug bindings are available. Site 1, also called as warfarin or azathioprine binding site. Site 2, also called as diazepam binding site. Site 3, also called as digitoxin binding site. Site 4 is also called as tamoxifen binding site. So let us discuss briefly these sites. Site 1, it represents the region to which the large number of drugs are bound. Several NSAIDs, phenylbutazone, naproxen, indomethacin, several sulfonamides, phenytoin, sodium valproate, and bilirubin are bound to the site 1 of the HSA or human serum albumin. While site 2, so let us come towards the site 2. Drugs which bind to this region includes benzodiazepines, medium chain fatty acids, ibuprofen, ketoprofen, tryptophan, cloxacillin, and probenecid, etc. Site 1 and 2 are responsible for binding of most drug as compared to site 3 and 4. A drug can bind to more than one site. The main site is called primary site and the other is called as secondary site. Groups of the drug that bind to same site compete with each other for binding, and this will be results in the drug interaction. So next, plasma protein is the binding of drug to the alpha 1 acid glycoprotein. It is also called as oromucoid. It has molecular weight of 44,000 Dalton and plasma concentration ranges of 0.04 to 0.1 gram per cent. It binds to number of basic drugs like mepramine, lidocaine, propranolol and quinidine. So now coming towards the third plasma protein, that is globulin, and the binding of drugs to the globulins. There are several plasma globulins and these are responsible for the plasma transport of the certain endogenous substances. These globulins have low capacity but high affinity for the binding of these endogenous substances, and there are different types of the globulins, and these are structural differences between these, and some of them are alpha 1 globulin, also called as transcorticosteroid binding globulin, CBG. It binds a number of the steroidal drugs, cortisone, prednisone. It also binds thyroxine and cyanocobalamin. Alpha 2 globulin, also called as ceruloplasmin. It binds vitamin A, D, E, K and cupric ions. Next is the beta 1 globulin, also called as transferrin. It binds to the ferrocyanin. Next is the beta 2 globulin. It binds to the carotenoids. Next, gamma globulin. It binds to the antigen. So there are different plasma proteins bind sites to the different drugs. So after discussing albumin, glycoproteins, globulin, the last one plasma protein is the lipoproteins. Lipoproteins are macromolecules, complexes of lipids and proteins, and they are classified on the basis of their density into four categories. Number one is the chylomicrons, least dense and largest in size. Number two is the very low density lipoproteins, which will be abbreviated as VLDL, low density lipoproteins LDL, high density lipoproteins HDL, most dense and smallest in size. Molecular weight will be 2 to 34 lakhs Dalton. The hydrophobic lipid core composed of triglyceride and cholesterol esters and hydrophilic surface is made of apoproteins. Because as the name indicates that this is the lipoproteins, means it contains complex of the lipids plus protein. So binding of drugs to lipoproteins is non-competitive and it binds to the lipoproteins by dissolving in the lipid core. Examples include acidic, diclofenac, neutral, cyclosporine. Basic, chlorpromazine binds to the lipoproteins. Lipoproteins are responsible for the transport of the plasma lipids to the liver. This is the function of the lipoproteins. It is also responsible of the binding of drugs if the albumin sites become saturated. So today we have discussed about the components of the plasma protein binding, and the first component was the blood, and in blood there are two components, that was plasma proteins and blood cells. So in today's lecture we have discussed different plasma proteins responsible for the drug binding. Next time we will discuss about the blood cell protein interactions or extravascular tissue proteins or tissue binding of the drug. So this is all about our today's lecture. Thank you.